Alrighty, in retrospect to that last video, the Aztec Gold Tour, it's about delivery of any of the donation to the people, indigenous tribes in Mexico. It'd be very difficult. It would have to be handled if you're going to give them to each one like a check. They don't even have checking accounts, so we're having that problem. They couldn't even get $50 a year from the benefits show that would display all the way around the United States or even international into Europe, which is quite exciting, to send the Aztec tour around. It's great, very museum-like and visitations, lots of tourists. So that type of a build, that type of a show, and you can even have, town for town, you can have audition of people that are looking Aztec-y, that can wear the garbs, special clothes and costumes. We can have photographs with those particular, like bringing them back to life. And so, the old women and the old men and the young women and the young men can have their photos taken with their favorite god or goddess of Aztec tribe in their garb, because we're silly that way. People are like to have that type of thing, so that kind of gives the show a little bit more momentum. And something different is, instead of just a crown jewels tour, how boring, it's going to actually have live, alive specimens of this indigenous look, and that really makes it, but they have to be like studs, of course. But yeah, that type of thing really kicks the show up to exciting. And so yeah, so that goes on with it. As but how do we get the money? Like, you have special donation money that goes to the current tribes, because right now I believe their lands are in like higgledy-piggledy. We're not sure if that's your land or somebody else's, and so then they start grabbing a gun and saying, well, it's my land, and so this is what's going on with Zapotecas, this is going on with this tribe over there, that tribe over there, and so they start fighting with Mexico, and then they end up with less of a tribe, and so it's a very devastating situation there. So we don't want them to have guns, we just want them to have land that is theirs. So a reserve system, I hate to say it, a real good reserve system, where they have land that is purchased, but then how do we make sure that it stays in their hands? How, that it's not grabbed out from the next person who takes a coup of Mexico? Because I do foresee Mexico as having a coup coming up soon, with the peso dropping again. I don't see it as a stable situation. I see it as becoming more of a war state. I hate to say it. I hate to say it, but this push already of Trump, of pushing so many immigrants back into Mexico, I don't see it as a good thing. I see it as a peso drop, a deletion again, and it's not a good direction to have a country so close to us that is not like, hey, this is France and Germany. We should really be like that. We should want that. We should want to have a real good economy country next to another good economy country. We should not just be, hey, we just want Turkey next to Germany. We don't want that situation. We want to have a very stable economy next to us. But instead, we have one that is pushy and that is bringing population, exorbitant population, again and again, more than keeping up with the United States. So the United States cannot keep up with that group. And that group, when they get bundled with guns and I don't want a war with Mexico. We cannot have a war with Mexico. Anyway, so this is what we have to avoid. We have to keep peace with Mexico. And it's getting serious. It's becoming a very serious situation. There are so many gang slayings down there. These terrible atrocities are going on. So there's just more and more fear And then when more fear happens, there goes the peso game. So we have a country that's just going to be taken over by any mafia that wants, any mafia that has the more weapons. So yeah, it's pretty rough, a rough situation. Anyway, I don't have the answer, but I just wanted to somehow save these tribes people in the middle of it all. The indigenous tribes people are in a very bad situation. Very bad. You know, where do you live? You know, type of situation. It's not. So anyway, how to get the money there? You can do armored vehicles drop off, and here's your $50 or your $50 worth in pesos. You can do it that way, but you still have to be some kind of armored vehicle that is delivering it. It becomes like instead of rice, we actually give them money, each one. Now, instead of doing it that way, though, because we still want them to have secure land, we need some writ with the Mexican government that assures that they have land, and that if we purchased it with a fund, you know, brought, you know, by these types of museum shows that tour around the United States and the world, that they would have secure land that would be always theirs, you know, just like we've done here in the United States, you know. I know this is another friction. There's the Mexico friction and the Mexican friction, and then there's the friction of the indigenous. But they're the ones that are the least cared for at this point. So that's what I wanted to do. Somehow get some for sure status of property for the tribes. Okay, and maybe that's what the tour could accomplish. All right.